What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Right now I am on my way to go get this truck aligned because if you guys saw last video where I put on the new tie rods, the alignment is so bad, so I need to go get it aligned.
Seriously though, look at this. That is how you go straight right there. That is straight.
And we just pulled up to the alignment shop. Right now I'm parking, about to go inside and get started. Hopefully we can get this thing aligned today. All right, I'll be right back.
All right, we'll be waiting on.
All right. Well, dang. So they basically told me that me trying to fix just the outer tie rods wasn't gonna work, and the inner tie rods actually needed to be changed as well. So I'm gonna go run up there and grab some inner tie rods. They're gonna change them out for me real quick and also align up real fast. So, oh well, at least we'll get that taken care of and it'll be done.
Pulling right back up to Advance Auto. I gotta run inside and grab those inner tie rods and I will be right back. Okay, I got the new tie rods. Let's go. They are waiting on me, so I'm gonna go run back up there and let them install these real fast and get the truck aligned and it will be good to go. It'll be done. They're still in there working on the truck, so me and Wade here, we're about to go grab something to eat. I got here at 10:30. They're still out there working on it. Jeez, this is taking forever. Judging by all the green on that screen right there, I think that they're almost done, so.
This TV, it's really annoying.
I've been in here for so long that my phone literally died. Completely dead.
Heard and saw in the Fed statement and that news conference today.
Guys, I just got the truck aligned. I'm finally on my way back home 4.5 hours later. I guess it took them a little bit to get the tie rods put on, but that's all right. The truck is aligned now properly, so it feels much better to drive and handles a lot better. It started raining a little bit earlier, but it looks like it's drying up now, so hopefully whenever we get home, I can change clothes and go back outside and get started on lowering the rear of this truck. As you guys saw, I got some hangers in to lower the rear down a little bit. And I'm gonna try to get those put on so we can test out and see what it looks like with the race wheels. Hopefully once I lower down the rear and get rid of a little bit of that wheel gap, it won't look as terrible with the race wheels on there, because I tried them on before and it was just, yeah, it looked awful. So we're gonna try and lower down the rear a little bit and get it to look good. Also, by lowering down the rear, hopefully it's gonna hook up a little bit better on those wheels too, because I have a huge announcement for you guys. We have something pretty gnarly coming for the truck, so make sure you guys stay tuned for the next few videos to find out what I'm talking about. It's gonna be nasty.
Okay guys, so we are about to get started installing these hangers that go in the rear of the truck to lower down the rear about 2 more inches, which in turn should eliminate the majority of this wheel gap. We've got Rob over here helping. We're gonna have to use this grinder here because let me get under here and show you guys why. So this is the stock hanger, right? This thing is gonna have to get cut out of there. There's rivets up there right here and up there at the top that actually hold this in place, and we're gonna have to cut those rivets out and then replace this one with the aftermarket hanger. And luckily the aftermarket one just bolts directly up, so it should be pretty easy. Well, we got to grinding down one of the rivets right here and we noticed that we don't know if it's gonna pop through, and then we started to notice that how in the heck are we gonna get a grinder up here to get these other 2 rivets out of there. So I'm not exactly sure what we're gonna do, but as of right now we're kinda stuck. I'm not sure how to get the rest of this out. I guess we're gonna have to try to hopefully, I don't know, take it to a shop with a blowtorch or something and torch it off.
That's honestly what I would do.
I don't have a blowtorch to get it off, unfortunately, so. I have no idea how to get that out. That kinda sucks.
It is pretty sketch.
So anyways, I'm going up to a local place here to go ask them if they can install them, which I've already talked to them and they said that they pretty much think that they can. They just want to see the hangers and what they look like. The new ones are easy. They just bolt in, but the old ones have to be cut out with a blowtorch. So the cool thing about this place is that it's actually a truck store and a gun store. So they have a gun range there. So I'm probably about to go grab a few of my guns and maybe do a little bit of shooting while we're there after I show it all to them. So let me go grab my AK and my KSU real quick and we're going to head over there. Alrighty, so I've got a few of the guns loaded up over there. We're gonna head over to the range and get started shooting, and I'm gonna let them know about those little hangers and see if they can get those installed. So let's go ahead and head over there. Okay guys, well a few hours later we finally got the truck back. I had a lot of fun. We went and shot and everything, and also while I was there at the range we actually got to be in a commercials, which was
pretty cool. Essentially, the gun range that just opened up, they wanted a commercial to broadcast on the news and everything around here on our local news station, and I got to be in it. They basically recorded me shooting at the range and stuff like that while I was waiting on the truck to get done. There was a few complications with the truck, but we'll talk about that in just a second. Everything was finished up, but there is a little bit of bad news to that, so give us just a second. We're about to pull back up at home, and I'll talk to you there.
Okay, guys, so here is the deal. As you see, the lowering hangers were installed right here on the back of the truck, but it didn't lower it down nearly as much as I was thinking that it was. You guys can see up there at the front how tiny that tire gap is, and now you see in the back how big this wheel gap is. I was really hoping to get that matched up, and the problem with that being is that the hangers that I got shipped to me, they were actually 1-inch hangers instead of 2-inch hangers, and the manufacturer misboxed them, or whatever you want to call it. They pretty much put the wrong product in the box whenever they shipped it out. But if you look up there in the front, you can kind of see right there they got the new hangers put in, which required the blowtorch and all of that like I was talking about. So I didn't get to do it here at home by myself, but the shop got it all taken care of. Unfortunately, it was a lot harder than they were anticipating, and it was the wrong size, so I paid a ton of money for them to have to drop the gas tank out of this truck, use a blowtorch, etc. It ended up being like $550 to get the wrong part installed onto the truck, and no one, including myself, knew that it was the wrong part until we got it installed onto it. So, kind of sucks. $550 later, here we are, 1-inch lower instead of 2 inches lower like I was anticipating, and this is where the really sucky part comes in. So let's check out in the back of the truck right here, and you see these are the traction bars that I had on the back of the truck, and it's going to be really hard to look, but on those leaf springs, essentially what it is these traction bars mount to the leaf spring in the front and the axle in the back. Ugh, and basically that helps out with traction. It really helps with wheel hop on these trucks, etc. So, but unfortunately with these aftermarket hangers, we're not able to mount the traction bars to the leaf springs like they go, because with these incorrect parts, they actually rub on the hanger. So it's a big mess. $550, like I said, 1 inch lower, and we had to eliminate the traction bars, which I'm gonna have to modify some way to get them on there, because with the mods that I'm planning on getting in this week, it's just not gonna work. I will have to have these traction bars on the truck. So it kind of sucks. It's not as low as I was wanting to, but at least it is lowered. So I mean, and that's not to say that it looks bad at all. It looks much better than what it did, for sure. I just wish that it was a little bit lower in the rear, but at least it's cleaned up a little bit. It looks a lot better for sure. So like I said, the only thing left is figure out how to mount those traction bars back onto the axle and leaf spring without having to modify the brackets and weakening them. Unfortunately, these brackets though are not gonna work with the hangers that we have on here, so I don't know, I'm gonna have to figure something out.
Well guys, I guess that's probably gonna be all for today's video. I was gonna test fit the race stars on here and everything, but I'm just a little bit bummed. Spent a lot of money, didn't get the results that I was wanting, and had to take off some of the parts that I had already put on there because they won't cooperate with the hangers. So I'm not exactly sure what I'm gonna do, but I have a few ideas in mind. I'm probably gonna try some more stuff in a later video, but for right now, that's probably going to be all. I'm just going to have to leave it like this for now, but it does look a lot better, I will say. If you guys are interested in seeing updated pictures of the truck now that it's lowered, make sure you go check me out on Instagram @itsjustasix. Thank you so much for watching. Till next video.